This is in response to Billy's Talking Points memo from Tuesday, December 2nd, 2014, President Obama and the Fergunson controversy. Don't know why you got to keep bringing it up again. I don't know what else you want to put in, what else you wanted to say about it, Billy. But I don't know where Obama fits into what your narrative was for today. It just was way out of there. So the first thing, so my position is, Obama's ahead of the country. He can affect the Justice Department. He can affect the Defense Department. We're militarizing our police way, way too much. And the Justice Department has a right and a duty to take a look at some of the practices, of police practices around the country, to determine whether or not they're really meeting, you know, with what's going on. There's obviously some bad apples everywhere, and that's why we have a Justice Department to check on all of that. But did you go into that? No. You go into immigration and talk about how President Obama is reeling from that. Well, actually, he's not reeling from that. We already know that the House doesn't have anything to do, and the Senate doesn't have anything to do in terms of, are they going to pass a bill? No. Are they going to attempt to pass a bill? No. Are they going to bitch and moan about it? Yes. Are they going to slightly infer that maybe we should impeach or censure or you know, cloture or whatever? Are they going to do that? Yes. What is actually going to happen? Nothing. Right? And the vast majority of Americans approve of what Obama did in terms of immigration, and they approve of the fact that we need to have a pathway to citizenship for these peoples. So I don't know where you're saying that that he's still in hot water, or that what did you say, he's mowing down the Constitution. So, but you have to put your dig in. So I know that that's important for you, and I know that you know, you want to get your digs in on Obama, but I don't know where you went to from there. Because after that, you showed a picture of Obama between two people, and I figured out who they were pretty quickly, because one of them was Charles Ramsey, pretty famous police chief who's known to be extremely heavy-handed, and him and the lady that were there are going to head some type of commission on how we can take a look at the Fergunson controversy and what types of things might be done to help alleviate that situation, not only in terms of how police interact with people of color, but how police departments act, how they react, what type of protocols do they need to have, et cetera, et cetera. But Charles Ramsey, you know, didn't have a great time when he was in D.C. He got sued a number of times, and he lost. He arrested a whole group of people somewhere. I don't remember where it was. I don't remember much about it, but it was a long time ago. It isn't like Obama's bringing someone in there who's going to go far left on this. He brought in a pretty mainstream chief of police. I believe he's chief of police now of Philadelphia. So whatever Obama's going to do on this, I'm not saying that it's going to be whitewashed. I'm going to say that it's going to lean heavily on the current protocols that police departments already have. And he probably is for the militarization of the police. So I don't know how far that commission is going to go and what type of recommendations, what actually can be done from it. If you're saying it, but you know, that's the way Obama's going right now. So I would assume that he's not going to say a whole lot about it. And again, one other thing, Billy, you know, don't fucking tell the president what he should or shouldn't do. Don't tell him to stay out of the controversy. He has a right and he has a duty to be involved in this type of thing. Now, are there a lot of other things going on in the United States he needs to be working on? Yes, but this has caught the nation. This is, you know, a media spectacle, and should he weigh in on it? Yes, I do believe he should weigh in on it. He hasn't said much. That's okay. Maybe he's doing worse things behind the scenes. So please don't tell the president not to get involved in all this stuff. I mean, you could pay $10 million a year just to open your fat mouth, you know, to ridicule other people who are trying to do good in this world, you know. And you know, it's bad enough you're doing it to them. You don't need to do it to the president. So then, and you know, this isn't even worth having almost. And then you bring in two other people. The first one was Charles Barkley, who basically indicated that we need the police because what would it be like without the police? And And the reason why I really wonder about this is, Charles Barkley, was a pretty good basketball player, and he's been known to have a huge mouth. People love to talk to him. People love to interview him because you never know what's going to come out of his mouth. One of his famous lines after one of his teams lost one day, and they asked him what he was going to do because the team just got crushed or something. He says, "Look, this is one of those days where you just go home and, beat your wife." This was probably like 20 years ago. 30 years ago, when he was first in the league, he had three best friends. One was Snickers, one was Baby Ruth, and the other one was Patron, or something in that order. And he's a great interview, right? But he's a marginal. He's not in the political scene, so I don't know why you even brought him in at all. And then you bring in Louis Farrakhan, who's 81 years old, he's been I understand his message. I understand him wanting to help the black person. I don't agree with the violence at all in any way, shape, or form. But he's also an extremely marginal player. So you bring in two marginal players. You criticize Obama, but you really didn't get into a whole heck of a lot. But then you brought up about the fact that you want everyone to have prosperity. We all need to work together. We all need to help out. Why don't you go work at a soup kitchen? A couple Saturdays, two Saturdays a month for the next year. Don't tell anybody. Not that anyone would not recognize you. Why don't you do that? And then that could be how you would help out. Why don't you advocate for a higher minimum wage? You have a bully pulpit too. You could do something. You want to help out? You want people so that they can work together? You want women to be empowered? Okay, that's one thing you can do. Raise the minimum wage. How about asking for all Republicans to employ to vote for the Employee Non-Discrimination Act? These are all things you can do, Billy. Instead of pontificating out there about how you want to, all we need to do is work together. All we need, we will have shared prosperity if we help each other out. That's a bunch of happy horse crap coming out of your mouth. Why don't you just do it. Do a soup kitchen, all right? You can think of enough stuff on your own. You don't need me to do this type of stuff. You want to show it, you do it. Me? Yeah, I do a few things. Two jobs, barely make enough to get by. So would I like to get rid of my job today if someone could pay me my salary for the next 20 years or so? Yes, I would love to do that. Would I volunteer? Yes, I would. I would volunteer for people who are in need. I would not necessarily do it 100%, but maybe 15, 20 hours a week. Yeah, I could do that. Why don't you do that, Billy? Why don't you help me out so that I can help out others?